This is Zuby Masters returning to my Let's Play of Sly 2, Band of Thieves. Let's continue on. Oops, wrong character. Alright. First, let's get this stealth slide. Now, let's first play searching for the treasure box around here. That's one. That's how you take on two flashlight guards. Alright then. Nothing here. There's another clue in a bottle. That makes three. Bronze pin. There we go. Got a silver pen now. Thank you. Connecting to the thief. Bronze ring. Narrow escape.
Thank you.
into Thief Man. There we go, silver medal. You served your purpose. There we go, silver ring. There we go, there's another one. It's 25. Silver ring. Bronze medal. Gold ring. Got another gold ring. Bye-bye. Silver ring. There we go. All right then. Alright, on, turn around, and there we go. No, no, dang it. Silver ring. There we go. Alright then, now time for the final treasure here. A scepter. All of our communications had here with that driven satellite array.
That's pretty grim. Okay. You got a plan for shutting it down?
Don't I always?
No ways. Now, the local spice plants are illegal for good reason.
Eat too many, and you'll go into a fit of horrible rage.
Keep that stuff away from Murray.
Oh wait, I get it. I put some spice plants in the elephant's feedback. He chows down, gets all crazy, and then presto! The satellite's in pieces.
A crude interpretation of the plan, but accurate. The trick here is harvesting the spice plants.
You'll have to do some serious climbing, as they only grow high up in the jungle canopy. Alright then. Sounds simple. That takes care of one. Spice plant. That's number three. Plant. spice plant. Whew, that was too close. Spice plant.
Sly, now take all the spice plants you've collected to the elephant's feed basket.
Alright. Sayonara, satellite array.
Is a rare Indian water bug. If you can carry it into Rajan's office, its wings will transmit local sound waves at a frequency I can monitor.
Let me get this straight. We're gonna bug Rajan's office with a bug?
It is an elegant plan, I agree. Now pay attention. That water bug can only survive in stagnant pools. If kept out of water too long, it'll become unhappy and likely draw the attention of local guards.
Looks like there's a few pools along the way to Rajan's office. A short swim every now and then should keep our little friend quiet.
Thank you.
There we go.
Excellent. I've already tuned in to the bug's wing vibrations. I'm a genius.
Yes. I wonder how that really works. Because I'm pretty sure it shouldn't.
Good thing I'm fluent in Sanskrit, or this last code would have been impossible. Try 386.
Here we go. Ooh, this looks interesting. We got the voltage attack.
You've got the voltage attack move!
Go, Bentley. Let's go.
As I expected, Rajan is out for his daily tour of the operation. My sources claim he always carries three blueprints on him, which when read together, tell you everything about his spice operation.
Too bad he doesn't have that section of the clockwork heart we saw during the recon. You could just pump him full of sleep darts and we could all go home.
Unfortunately, my sleep darts aren't powerful enough to affect Rajan.
What? How are you gonna get at those blueprints?
Rajan has an insatiable appetite for Indian watermelons, which, if eaten whole, will force even him to nod off for a while. Once he's asleep, I'll creep in and lift the blueprints.
Well, that's fine and all, but how do you plan on luring him over to the watermelons?
I've equipped my sleep darts with a sonic disruptor. The strange sounds they make should be enough to lead the ever-curious Rajan from place to place.
Spice Operation Blueprint. There's the second watermelon. Thank you. spice operation.
Viper in the grass!
Dang it.
What? The blueprints! They have been stolen!
Nice, Bentley.
That's the complete set of blueprints. Great field work, Bentley. You're really getting the hang of this.
Job complete. Bentley.
I've got some bad news. Rajan has gone into hiding somewhere in the temple. I guess the destruction of his satellite array and my invasion of his personal space to get the blueprint spooked him. To get his portion of the clockwork heart, we'll need to drive him out into the open. Given Rajan's spice-addled temper, I'd recommend making him angry. First, we'll destroy the center of his operation, the spice grinder. Then we'll demolish the dam above the temple in an attempt to flood him out. If that doesn't work, I've made arrangements to exchange one of the temple's facade rubies for some high explosives, which, if necessary, we can use to flood the whole temple grotto. If my psychological profile is accurate, Rajan should pick up the other half of the clockwork heart before making his escape, effectively bringing it to us.
Well, that's it for this video. Hope you like it and stay tuned.